Hi all, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to discuss with you about grade 10 physics. Topic is reflection of light, chapter and subtopic is formation of image in plane mirror by the point objects. So how a point object image will be formed in the plane mirror, that we are going to see in this video by using the ray diagrams. In physics, in this light chapter, we draw lots of ray diagrams, and in exams also they are asked, so you have to understand these topics well, and drawing also you have to practice to draw it in the examination. So let's begin this topic. Object gives out large number of rays in all the directions, but we cannot draw all so many rays which are coming out of the objects. So while drawing, we draw only two light rays coming from the object and they are shown. So this keeps the ray diagram simple. So one ray we prefer to draw from the top of the object and the one from bottom of the object. So this is how we draw the rays. So and how do we draw the rays? The real rays represented by dotted by full lines like this, dark lines, and the virtual rays are represented by dotted lines. What are virtual rays and real rays? That I'll discuss with the ray diagram when I'm showing the ray diagram. So real rays, they exist in front of the mirror, and the virtual rays are shown behind the mirror, which actually do not exist. So they are just appear to be coming from behind the mirror. So this is the real rays and virtual rays. So this is a point formation of image in a plane mirror by the point size object. So object is O and the image is I. This M and M dash is a mirror. From the object O, one ray is hitting the mirror here, OA, and it is reflected from the mirror. The arrow is shown that this is an incident ray, and after reflection it is going away from the mirror, so the arrow is shown like this. For this ray, this is a normal, and this is angle of incidence and angle of reflection, which are same for this ray. The another ray which is coming out of the object is from bottom of it, and it is hitting the point B of the mirror and going into the eyes at point Y. Again, angle of incidence and reflection are same for both, and this is an I. And if you extend this rays behind like this, you get the image I of the object O, point size object O. So this is how the image is formed. And in the plane mirror, the image will be similar to that of the object. Object is point size, so image will also be point size. So this is the diagram, ray diagram, for the image formed by the point objects on the plane mirror. So the small object O, or point source of light, is placed in front of the mirror. Mirror forms the image I of object O, and object O gives out light rays in all the directions. And this way I have explained you the entire diagram. Let us see further what is there in this topic. The image formed by a plane mirror can be seen only by looking into the mirror. If we don't look into the mirror, we cannot obtain the image of it. If the screen is placed in the position I, no image is formed. If we put the screen, we do not get the image, because as the rays actually do not pass through point I, it appears to be touching the point I, but actually they are not going backwards in the mirror. So it just appears to do so. This type of image is called virtual image, which cannot be obtained on screen. So light rays shown behind the mirror are dotted lines, are imaginary lines, light rays. They are imaginary light rays. Here in this diagram, dot diagram, this are the strong rays, or the full lines we have drawn. These are the real lines which are coming out from the object, the real rays. This is extended, we tend to be extended behind, which are not really the rays, but only an imagination. So these are dotted lines. So this is how we draw the ray image diagrams. So there can be no real light rays behind the mirror, because it has silver reflecting surface at back, which does not allow light rays to pass through it. So this is what it is. So I hope this topic of reflection of light by the point size object is clear to you. Subscribe my channel for more educational videos, and like and share it with your friends, and refer my channel for chemistry, biology, all types of videos. Thank you for watching.